This is nursing 234, skill number 2, IV push medication. The first thing we're going to do, our patient already has their IV inserted into their forearm. They're getting normal saline infusing at 15 mils an hour. And we're going to give an IV push medication through that. We're going to have our drug called Toradol or Ketorolac. And we're going to grab this book and look up the rate of administration. The little blue header. And it says evenly distributed over 1 to 2 minutes is preferred. We have 1 mil of that, and our equation is seconds per line. If you need help calculating this, stop by my office and I'll be glad to help. So we're going to get our Ketorolac ready. I have a 1 mil syringe, and I have my needles to draw up my medication. And Joint Commission wants you to med prep at the patient's bedside, but you may do it in the med room with an instructor also, and just make sure you label the syringe with the patient's name, date of birth, and what medication's in here, so you know where you're going. You're going to scrub to prevent infection. So our seconds over line, 120 seconds, and I have 10 lines for 1 ml. So 120 divided by 10 is 12, and you want to round up to a nice even number on your watch, so you round up by 5. So if it's 12 seconds, I'd round up to 15. So I'm going to push this fit medicine evenly distributed 15 seconds a line. I'm going to get a 10 ml syringe flush of saline, and I'm going to get some alcohol swabs. And I'm going to come over here, and you want to use the port closest to the patient. You're going to scrub it. You're going to, before you give any medicine, you're going to verify the patient's name and date of birth and scan it with the electronic MAR. You're going to discard the air that was in there. You can occlude this right here and pull back to see if you get blood return. If you don't get blood return, that's okay. And I know that normal saline, I forgot to mention this, I know normal saline is compatible with Toradol because normal saline is an isotonic solution. If it wasn't compatible, I would need to stop the fluids and disconnect the IV tubing from here, at your extension port. And then flush saline, give the medicine, and flush saline. But because I know it's compatible, I'm okay. So I'm going to flush this. I'm going to flush 5 mLs. And I get in the PowerPoint, there's a link to use that accesses HRH. It's called Care Notes. And it'll check compatibility. If you have questions, you can ask. I'm going to sit this alcohol swab down and put my syringe on top of it because that can get contaminated. I'm gonna swab again. So as you're in your last year of nursing school, you want to keep lots of alcohol pens in your pocket so you're ready to clean anything. Okay, so I have my little syringe and I'm gonna screw this on, and if the recorder wants to get closer, I'm gonna push and then I'm gonna wait 10 seconds. And that's why you need to have a real secondhand watch so your watch doesn't shut off every 10 seconds. Oh, actually, it was 15 seconds. I'm sorry, 15 seconds. So every 15 seconds you're going to push, because 120 seconds divided by 10 lines equals 12 seconds per line, and you want to round up to 15. So it's been 15 seconds. I'm going to push. And as you're pushing, you just want to slowly talk to the patient, tell them what medicine you're giving, what side effects are available. If they have any questions that you can help answer during their care while they're here at the hospital of HLGU. make sure you're, while you're giving this, you're going to assess the IV site for phlebitis and inflammation. And if you don't see any of that, that's excellent. And you're going, some of the nurses at HRH don't always give medication like we do, the seconds per line, but it is the safest way to give medication as you practice as a nurse. So remember to do that. Now, if you're talking to the patient and you forget to push in your 15-second intervals and it's, say it's been 20 seconds, that's okay. You're not going to hurt the patient. The problem is when you push medications too fast, you're going to hurt and possibly kill the patient. And I'm making you experience the whole 2 minutes because 2 minutes really is a long time. Longer than you think in your head. You think 2 minutes in class, that goes by really fast sometimes, but just being unable to understand that 2 minutes is a long time. And when you do IV push medications, you do have to have an instructor with you. So you can't give IV medications alone. So the instructor may say to a student, go give your PO meds, then I'll come find you to give your IV push medication. So always wait for them. And I have another, 15 seconds left to finish this off. And you say, how's that doing? And if I'm giving you Tordal, because it's an NSAID, there's the last one. You want to assess their pain before you give them medication and 15 to 30 minutes after you give it. And I'm wiping this again. Then you're going to take your flush. And the first 2 mils, you want to push 15 seconds a line. Because you don't want to just give a bolus of the medication that's lying in the tubing. And patients understand that you're providing excellent care to them. And they're happy. They're smiling all the time. And after you flush those first 2 mils, you can flush the rest of the medicine just nice, slowly, and easy. So you're not giving a bolus. And then disconnect it. They're good to go. And make sure when you're pushing the medicine that you're not pulling on them. You're just giving it nice and slowly. So you might have to sit, pull up a chair if they're in bed, or raise the bed up to your working height so you're not hurting your back. You're going to throw all your trash in the trash can. You're going to discard your needle in a sharp container. Okay, and now we're going to pretend that Mr. Smith needs another medicine. And I'm going to find, I think, if you give me a minute. I think I like Benadryl. Yeah, Benadryl's great because it's 1 minute. So we're going to draw up some Benadryl. And I'm going to stop this pump and turn it off. And I left my blue cap out there, but you put a blue cap over this so it doesn't get contaminated. You don't want it just to hang there. So I'm going to draw up my Benadryl. And I'm going to give 25 milligrams per 1 ml. There's my 1 ml of Benadryl. And we're going to give 60 seconds, because it says to give over 1 minute. And that, does that make sense to calculate 60 seconds for 1 minute? We're going to verify their name and birth date. And they say the correct name and birth date. And Mr. Smith doesn't have any allergies. So lucky for us, we're safe to administer this. And I have a flush. We'll just use a 3 ml one before and after. Make sure you get the air out because you don't want to give them an air embolism. So So 60 seconds divided by 10 lines is 6 seconds a line. Because we are awesome math majors. And then, okay, so then we're going to come over here. And this is because they don't have 6 seconds, we're going to round up to 10 seconds. They don't have an IV fluids running anymore. So I'm going to get some more alcohol. I'm going to scrub this. And then I'm going to flush the medicine, the saline, not the medicine, the saline. You're going to push a little and then you can pull back. If you don't get blood return, that's okay. It's just always nice to have the blood return so you know you're in the vein. And you're just going to push this first 3 mils nice and slowly. And then we're going to discard that. And then we're going to get our Benadryl. And Benadryl can be used for lots of things, but mainly for itching. In the ER, you give it a lot in IV form instead of PO because it's faster acting. And then we're going to do, I'm going to attach it. And I'm going to do 10 seconds a line. And this one will go a lot quicker because 10 seconds is faster than 15. I'm only going to push half a mil so you can see. I just wanted you to see how different it was compared to being connected to the IV pole. You're going to disconnect this. I'm going to get my next saline, or not my alcohol and my saline. Scrubbed it. And then you're going to push for the first mil, if it's a 3 mil syringe, you're going to push the first minute at 10 seconds a line. 10 seconds and push. Wait 10 seconds on your watch. And then after you push 2 mils of that, you can push the rest of the saline in. If you have questions or you need help in regards to doing this clinical calculation, it's a new ClinCalc problem. You'll have 5 questions of these on your test. So you're ready for the checkoff so you don't fail the checkoff. Come stop by my office or email me. Thank you.